So when I chose to become an Ironblood, I made a promise to myself. I swore that if he ever strayed from his path or reached his breaking point, I would stop him by taking his life. That became my goal. It gave me a reason to remain in this world, even when I'd been unable to stop my dad. Of course, the one who settled things for the old man ended up being Schwarzer, his real son. There's no shortage of fires that need putting out right now. One wrong move, and the continent is liable to fall apart. Atoning for putting it in the position it's in through rebuilding the Empire is a good, honest goal. It's something worth doing. But at the same time, I think I've lost my purpose in life all over again, old man.
Thank you.
Even if they aren't on the best terms with them, Claire and Rufus still have families. Milliam and Altina have people they can turn to now, too. Everyone's got someone who loves them that they can go back to. But me? Getting close was never really my thing. Every chance I had, I chose to walk away. All that's left of me are the sins I have to atone for. If nothing else, I can at least make it so work's not left a complete mess. Damn it! There I go, thinking about work again. When did I become that kind of guy? Huh? Was that Sieg?
There you are. I've been looking everywhere.
Busted, huh?
Finding you slacking off on a rooftop brings back memories. I'll never forget how much legwork I put in trying to find you at Genus.
Oh, I bet you won't.
I know I won't understand everything that's burdening you right now. I'm sure there are things that, even if you told me, I wouldn't be able to imagine with my upbringing. But I know you're the same person you are now as you were the day we met. When I felt lost and was struggling with my own internal conflicts, you were the one who reached out to me. I've never stopped being thankful for it, Lecter.
You remember all that? I feel bad, but I barely remember anything that happened in school.
Maybe you've forgotten, but we haven't. You were the weirdest student council president ever. A guy who wouldn't know common sense if it hit him in the face. There was no end to your shenanigans. But you also saved us more than we can count. More than we realized at the time. You're really important to us, Lecter. And you always will be. So, please don't suffer in silence. We want you to be your true self in front of us. Even if you can't with anyone else.
I've got people too. Guess I just wasn't thinking straight. That means the world to me, Chloe. Lucy. I feel like as long as I've got you, I'll never have to worry about losing my way.
What? Are you all right? You're not delirious from fever or anything, are you?
That hurts, you know. Well, whatever. I'd better get going. I've been hanging up here too long as it is. You good on time, Chloe? You've got a flight soon, right?
I do, but it isn't due to take off for a half hour or so. This isn't an official visit, so Julia is coming to escort me back.
She might be waiting at the landing port as we speak. Jill, Hans, and Leo are in Liberal right now, isn't that right?
They should be. Oh!
Oh dear, I suppose that means work will have to wait.
If we pass up this opportunity now, who knows when we'll get a next time?
Why are you both talking like that?
You're coming with us!
Wait, what? You're not dragging me all the way to Liberal, are you?
Of course we are. We can finally have that reunion we've been itching for after all this time.
You'll never have a day off if we don't kidnap you.
We can still talk about this.
Nope.
Spare me, please!